Hello friends, my name is Supriya Mogle. I am working as an assistant professor at Center for Distance Education, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. I am here to discuss about international economic cooperation and agreement. It is one of the important topic of international business. So first we'll see regional economic integration. It is also known as trade blocs. It means agreement between group of countries in geographical region to reduce and ultimately remove tariff and non-tariff barriers to the free flow of goods, services and factors of production between each other. Okay. So what is tariff and non-tariff barriers? Tariff means a tax which has to be paid on goods coming into a country from other country. And non-tariff barriers means trade barriers that restrict imports or exports on goods and services. The next is types of integration. First is free trade area. Free trade area includes free trade between two countries and it abolishes all the restrictions on trade. Then common market. Common market allows free movement of labor and capital within the common market. Custom union. It eliminates all the restrictions on trade and adopts a uniform commercial policy. Economic union. Economic union is the process of creating common standards across internal market. Both participant countries have both common policies on product regulation, freedom of movement of goods or services, and common external trade policy. Economic integration. It means removal of all the barriers, unification of social and economic policies. So the next is the European Union. So what is European Union? It is an economic and political association of certain European countries as a unit with internal free trade and common external tariffs. So in this union, there are total 27 countries and these are all European countries. So there are some policies regarding international trade which are applicable for these member countries only. Okay, suppose out of 27, two countries are not agreed with some policies, then it will not be applicable for that two countries. Okay, it is running like a cooperation. Next is, what are the main policies of the European Union? The first and foremost is free movement of people, means anyone can freely move from one country to another country. There is no need of passport or visa. But this policy is not applicable to the Ireland and UK because they are not agreed with this policy. So it is not applicable to these countries. The next is free movement of goods. You can easily import and export the goods from one country to other country. But the note. Recently, one debate is going on. UK wants exit from European Union, but other countries' members are not agreed with this because they know if UK takes exit, it will have bad impact on international trade. Next is main bodies of the European Union. In this diagram, you can see European Commission, the Council of European Union, European Parliament, European Council, then European Court of Justice, Economic and Social Committee, and Committee of the Regions. So first we'll see European Council. So it is made up of the leaders of each of the country which is member of European Union, and it defines the European Union's overall political direction and priorities. Okay, then we'll see European Commission. It is the European Union's executive arm. It makes decision on the Union political and strategies direction. Okay, means some innovative policies or main agendas are prepared and executed by this body, and they will say whether they are implemented properly or not. Third one is Council of the European Union. Okay, sometimes it is called as Council of Ministers. It negotiates and adopts the legislative acts in most of the time together with the European Parliament. European Parliament. It also coordinates the economic and security policies. Then next is European Parliament. So what is European Parliament? These members are directly elected by citizens of European Union, and Parliament acts as a co-legislator, and they decide the budget of European Union. They amend legislative proposals, and also they supervise the work of Commission and other European Union bodies. Then next is European Court of Justice. Okay, if suppose you have any disputes regarding the barriers or regarding tax dispute between two countries, or there is having some grievances in the countries, then you are going to have your Court of Justice in which the grievances or disputes are resolved. Then next is Economic and Social Committee and Committee of the Regions. These are written advice, means these are advisory groups. Okay, Economic and Social Committee, it is a non-political body that gives representatives of Europe's civil society and express the opinions on the issues of European Union. Suppose in the Court of Justice there are some issues between two countries, then they are going to have advice to them. Then next is Committee of the Regions. Here 350 representatives are there of regional and local government working to increase the participation. So these two are advisory group of European Union. So I hope you understood the European Union concept. I hope you cleared the idea. Thank you so much.